better.
Okay, good. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and call the finance meeting to order. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Meany?
Here.
Councilman Plunis?
Here.
Councilman Zellin?
Here.
Okay, items requiring legislation. Item number one, authorizing the purchase of uniform rental and facility services from Cintas Corporation through U.S. Communities Cooperative Purchasing Program, terms for use by various city departments.
This is me. This is through finance. This is really a reset on the existing agreement with Cintas. City's been using them since, at least since 2015. Mm-hmm. At the time, as I note in the memo, council had approved a three-year agreement. The agreement language was actually 5 years. After speaking with representative from Cintas, they had informed us that they are on the U.S. Communities Cooperative as a contract. So we're looking to piggyback onto the U.S. Communities contract with Cintas for the same services through 2022. We're actually getting pricing at or below the contract terms with U.S. Communities. So we're maintaining the same price list by making this change. So really what we're looking to do is reset through 2022 for those contractual services. We'll probably spend less than $30,000, so we have an estimate in there. Last year, the city spent just under $28,000 for the services. It's mainly uniforms. Right. We're doing some floor mats and some other facility type services across the city as well through the contract.
Okay. Any questions?
This is already budgeted in the...
Correct. Yeah. Yes.
Nothing else.
Any questions?
All right.
Okay.
I move to adopt legislation renewing the Cintas contract through the U.S. Communities Contract Cooperative through the year 2022. At approximately $30,000 per year.
I'll second. I just have one question.
Under emergency, sorry.
I just have one question. If we're moving this to until 2022, what is our out clause on it?
I think it's a standard. I believe it's a 60-day written notice on the out clause. There are also there's some other language as far as an amount that we would owe Cintas if we were to get out. And we did look at other pricing through other cooperatives, and this is for what we're doing, this is the best option. So I don't foresee a reason we would need to get out, but it's the contracts that you find on these cooperatives are fairly standard. It's usually between a 30 and 90 day notification to get out, and that's fairly standard through the cooperatives. And that's one of the benefits, because they know the type of language that local governments are looking for, and what they don't want is something too onerous if we want to remove the city from the agreement.
Okay, thanks.
Right. Are you second, Bob?
Oh, yes.
Okay, so you have a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Plunis?
Yes.
Councilman Zellin?
Yes.
Okay, item number two, authorizing the purchase of lockers from Schiffler Equipment Sales through the Buy Board Cooperative Purchasing Program contract pricing for use at the Solon Community Center. Matt?
This is part of the capital plan. We had budgeted $45,000 for replacement of lockers at the community center. And they were working with finance. Recreation Department was able to find the equipment they're looking for. And I think these are plastic lockers, which are more durable. And we weren't able to find exactly what they're looking for through some of the cooperatives that we have current authorization. You know, we have 8 cooperatives that council gave us authorization to utilize. So they're able to find something through a cooperative called Buy Board. It's a cooperative purchasing program. They have an estimate of just over $37,000, so we're looking for authorization for $40,000. I know that was not on the agenda based on the spec they have right now. So we're basically looking for two things with the legislation. One is really a one-time authorization to use the Buy Board cooperative contract, and two is to make the purchase of the lockers an amount not to exceed $40,000, so slightly below the budget in the capital plan for 2018.
Okay, any questions?
I'll move to have legislation prepared A under suspension for the reason that we need to purchase these items for the community center to participate in the Buy Board Cooperative Purchasing Program, and B to award the bid of Scranton Tuffic Solid Plastic for the lockers from Schiffler Equipment Sales.
I second.
Okay, motion and second. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Plunis?
Yes.
Councilman Zellin?
Yes.
Okay, item number three, authorizing the purchase of various fuel supplies through the State of Ohio Department of Administrative Services cooperative purchasing terms by the Service Department for use by various city departments. Mr. Jurcik?
Yes, this is the same fuel contract that the department has used through the last two contract periods of this contract. It is set to expire at the end of June, and the new one is going to be into effect July 1st, 2018 through 2021. They don't have a vendor. There is a vendor in place right now, but they won't disclose it because there is a they added fuel testing this, and the fuel testing results haven't been released yet. So next week we'll actually have the vendor, but it's the same contract that we've used for the past 7 or 8 years, and it works very well for the service department and everything else. 24 hours notice, and you know, and their service is here. So I'd like to continue to use the contract.
Any questions?
No. I move to create legislation to utilize the state DAS contract to continue to purchase fuel and request that the legislation be prepared under emergency so we can utilize the full extent of the contract terms.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Palunas?
Yes.
Councilman Zellman?
Yes.
Okay, item number 4, authorizing the Director of Finance to advertise a request for proposals for video rendering and production services in conjunction with the city's master plan. Are you here for this, Jim?
Sure.
Sounded interesting.
Yeah, it should be fun. I'm
like that 21st century stuff.
Yeah, so as my memo that you guys have says, we're looking to take the 400 plus page version of the city's master plan, turning it, you know, taking it to the next logical step of, you know, of a more marketable item in today's electronic times. So I sent you the link for one of the examples of the videos. If you don't mind, I'd like to play just for anybody for YouTube.
Sure.
And whatever else.
And this is Dublin, correct?
Yeah, this is what Dublin had done for a downtown area that they're redeveloping. So as you see, it's just a simple marketing tool to help, you know, that they'll design the buildings according to how our materials are stated in the master plan, do area, you know, take drone footage, make sure they're fully insured. I believe I included an example of the RFP we're looking to use. So again, this is just to authorize us to go out for that RFP. Are there any questions?
Well, I know we don't know this yet, but what would the anticipated cost for a 60 to 90 second video be?
What's the amount we're doing the budget amendment for in the next?
The next item we have, we're asking to appropriate $30,000.
I think it's a little high.
Well, I can tell you that we did some initial research, and that that actually is right about spec on where, from three different people. The least expensive option, I believe, was just shy of $25,000. So.
For 90 seconds?
Yep, because it's the amount of time it takes to do that sort of video rendering and do it in the styles that are asked for here. I can tell you from the minute amount of content creation experience or people that I've seen do it, it's a time intensive process, and the software to do it is also not cheap.
Have we looked into having the College of Urban Studies or Case Western schools do it as a graduate project or something
a capstone
like
project from
yes.
CSU or something? We haven't yet. That's a worthwhile idea. I don't know that. Do you think that should keep us from advertising the RFP? Because technically, we're not asking to approve the results of the RFP, just to go out to advertise for it. So we could have that in hand while speaking with those sorts of universities and kind of have two trains leaving the station, if you know what I mean.
Well, that would be fine. That would be fine. I just think that we should look at it because we can maybe do it for no cost at all to the city if we can do it through a program through Cleveland State or Case Western or even through Kent State if they have a graduate program in this area.
Right. No, I think that's worth reaching out to. I agree.
I got a question for Rob. Rob, a video like this, so to Bob's point, you know, we're talking 60 to 90 seconds. What kind of, I understand it's out to market the city, but what kind of return or value is this providing the city on the back end?
I mean, I think it would be a very valuable project for the city. I mean, the city needs to project a positive image of itself, both to its residents, so residents understand that the issues that they see, that there is a plan to address them externally to different to people outside of the city, to show that this is a progressive city, a place to build, to invest, to live. And we do have our master plan. The master plan has thousands of hours to prepare it. There was substantial citizen input in it. If I do say so myself, it's a good master plan. It won the state of Ohio or the American Planning Association best master plan process in the state of Ohio. So we have a lot good going for us, but the problem is, I think, and probably you all have seen this, probably only 25%, maybe less, people know we have a master plan. You're always hearing that we need to redevelop the downtown area, we need to have a plan. There is a plan. And I think that this would be, though it's 90 seconds, it's a very powerful tool. I think if you put that onto the website, onto the Facebook page, you'll never again have anybody questioning or not knowing whether the city has a master plan or not. And the only other thing I would point out would be that document, the only investment we've ever made in our master plan was through the attitude survey. Otherwise, there was no cost to the master plan. This would be the first investment in the master plan that we've ever made. And I think being visual in the way that people get information nowadays, they like to use their phones and their tablets. They're not going to read that big, long document. When they see that vision, when they get onto the website and they see that video, or they go to the Facebook page or they go to YouTube, whatever, and see that, I think that is really going to address a big problem we've had, and that people internally and externally do not know that we have a master plan.
Yeah, I don't have an issue going out with the RFP. I do have an issue amending the budget at this point to fund anything, because I'd like to see the other options if they're available. If they are, we can do that. If not, then we have to go look at the cost of doing this. So I think it is valuable, but I just want to see if we can get some other alternatives first.
Is there any issue in advertising the RFP without having the budget amended prior?
There's no issue per se. It's different from the normal course of action. Usually, if you think of the ongoing things we go out to bid or RFP for, usually they're set up in the budget prior to advertising for competitive solicitation. It's not a requirement. We have, first thing is to get authority to actually advertise. My recommendation would be to appropriate. If for some reason we don't go down this path with a professional services contract, we could always amend the budget and reduce the monies we're requesting to appropriate today. So it's not permanent if we increase. Thing is, if we go through the whole process and there's no viable option when it comes to a university program or some other low or no cost option, and we find a workable contractual services approach, the appropriations there and it's in place, and there won't be any additional delay. So that's why, that's my one caveat.
We could always have a special meeting though and appropriate the money. So that's not
it's council's.
It's not a big. It's really option. Not a huge. Yeah, you know, we meet all the time, so we could always have, and we're talking about a video. We're not talking about anything emergency for health, safety, or welfare of the residents. This is just a video, 60 to 90 seconds. That's going to go on the website, so I don't see a problem in waiting to appropriate the funds.
I prefer to follow the same process that we do with the other stuff, because if we don't find an option, then we can just appropriate it back versus having another meeting for it. I mean, prefer to follow the same process that we do on most of the other items. And I think it's worth looking into, and I think it could be very valuable for the city.
Yeah, I mean, I having been on finance all the time, because Bob, usually that's what we do. I mean, we appropriate, and as Matt said, I mean, if it ends up that we find somebody, you know, we can always shoot it back into the budget. It doesn't mean that, you know, I just think to get this thing going, because I truly do think it's a great idea. I think this is, like I say, when I said, you know, the 21st century, this is, people want to be able to, boom, look on our website, boom, hey, this is what the city would like to do. This is the city's, you know, for the future. This is what our master plan was. So, I mean, I just think this would be a really great tool for the city to have. And I'd like to, you know, move forward, you know, to me as quickly as possible. I think Bob's idea, though, of going and checking with universities, I think, you know, why not utilize, I mean, we have some really great universities right around us, and let's check and see if, you know, possibly, you know, as Bob said, somebody, you know, one of the schools, you know, somebody in the graduate work or whatever may want to take this on and could provide us with a really great video and for little to no cost to us.
So I've seen some of the work, Nancy. Mm-hmm. I've seen some of the work that some of the people at the Urban Affairs School have done from Cleveland State, as well as from Case Western. They come in front of the Cleveland Board of Building Standards quite often, and they come in front of some of the other Cleveland Planning Commission, some of the other subcommittees they'll come in front of, and they'll have great presentations, and they'll do it for credit. So I've seen some of the work they do, and they do with the computer design and everything else, and I've seen it, and it's just great quality work. And if we can get that at no expense to the city, I think it's something that we really should look at. I mean, because it's really, you know, as good, if not, you know, what's better, because we're not paying for it.
Agreed. And yeah, if you have contacts, you know, whether it's professors, you know, people who lead those programs, I'd be happy to, I'll just reach out on my own. But I agree, that would be a great course of action.
I'll contact, I know one of the architects who was at a presentation I was at in front of the Board of Building Standards a few weeks ago, so I'll contact him to see if he knows how to get a hold of the people.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I think that would be great. That's a great idea, Bob, like I say. But I, you know, do think I would rather, you know, just so we can get this going of still appropriating, we can always pull it back off, right? Yeah, that's not an issue if we end up getting, okay. So I don't think it really is, you know, it's really the way we've always done it when we've gone out for proposals. We have the money there available. And if it ends up that we're able to, you know, find someone at a university, you know, great. If not, then everything's in place. And
do you want to hold this for a meeting so we can determine whether we're going to do that? Because it's not really, if we put it out for proposal and then we find someone, we're wasting people's time in replying if we find someone who's willing to do it from university. I don't care either way.
Well, Jim, I mean, I know you've got a lot on your plate, but I mean, how quickly do you think you could reach out to the schools? I mean, what's your time frame of how quickly you think you can, you know, find an answer to whether, I mean, it is summertime, so I don't know.
Right. Well, yeah,
you know, that's the other issue
point.
Is, you know, probably there really aren't a lot of kids in school right now.
Yeah, and they have to be on their track, you know, at that time to design that, you know, to have that project and, you know, those due dates. I'm not familiar with those schedules well enough. I mean, I can, I think you ask most people that I work with, I can be pretty persistent about things. Mm-hmm. But again,
I think you're right on that, Nancy, because if we do wait to go to speak to people at school, it's June now and they've either graduated or they're not going to be doing programs during the summer.
Right.
So let's go. I'm fine going forward with the RFP.
Okay.
And then I disagree on the appropriations, but we'll get to that.
Okay. That's the next item.
You want to take this one and I'll take
either way. Okay. I'll move that we authorize the Director of Finance to advertise requests for proposals for video rendering and production services in conjunction with the city's master plan. And I have, after 3 seconds, I have one more comment.
A second.
Okay. I have a motion and a second. Go ahead, Matt.
Have we looked at doing this under LPV's contract?
We did talk to LPV about this sort of contract. They have a plethora of tools for doing live video and that, this the 3D rendering, as I said, those tools are extremely expensive. And so unless you're really focusing on that line of business, it's not cost effective for them. And so Peter and I were just having a conversation before the meeting, and that it was not something that they had the staffing to handle.
Okay.
And tools right now.
Understandable.
Okay, so I have a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Palunas?
Yes.
Councilman Zellner?
Yes.
Okay, item number 5. Budget amendments to general fund budget, A, general administration, fund 100, additional appropriation and other expenditures to fund professional services.
This is, again, we are requesting to amend the general administration budget by $30,000 based on the initial research prior to release of an RFP for the video rendering services. A correction on item 5, it should say refer to item 4, not item 3. Apologize for that. So again, we're looking to amend the budget by $30,000 for the potential professional services contract.
Any questions?
All right, I move to approve or to create legislation for the proposed amendment to the general administration budget for the rendering video services of $30,000.
I'll second.
Oh, under emergency, excuse me.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Palunas?
No.
Councilman Zellner?
Yes.
Okay. Item number 6, authorizing the payment of amounts due for which the finance director has issued then and now certificates. Matt?
Yeah, we had two items that were $3,000 or above that require legislative approval. Again, these items were all paid from a purchase order and are part of the approved budget. And we're seeking approval for the May 2018 then and now certificates.
Okay, any questions? Okay, I'll entertain a motion.
You want me to do it?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll move to forward legislation to council approving the two then and now certificates as an emergency, because these two need to be paid due to obligations the city has incurred in the amount of $3,970 to PNC Bank and to Data Command LLC in the amount of $12,572.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Palunas?
Yes.
Councilman Zellner?
Yes.
Okay, we'll move on then to discussions. Matt, do you have any updates for us now?
I will, as I mentioned, yeah. Email that I'll distribute the May report early this week.
Great.
Had a few people out the past week or two.
Right.
Back on top of things.
Okay.
And we'll have our June report at the July meeting.
Okay.
And this will be the last time that I will be clerking the meeting. Should have someone in place starting next week, and they will be here at the next meeting now.
Great.
You're staying.
Okay, I'll stay.
Such a good job.
It's my pleasure.
Okay, so we'll get then our reports soon. Okay. Okay, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Palunas?
Yes.
Councilman Zellner?
Yes.